Okay, guys, now we are continuing with the solo drills. We have done a few of them before, the shoulder throw, the head and arm throw. Now we're going to move on to the souplesse, quite common and very popular, very famous technique in wrestling. So this one is very difficult to do on a live opponent, you know, sometimes, especially if you haven't done it before, it's a danger of breaking opponent's head, breaking his neck. So best way, again, with somebody who does not complain and does not feel pain, that's the dummy. So the way you do the souplesse, sometimes you can do on a crash mat. If there is a crash mat, you can do it. If you have developed the confidence and you've done some bridges before that, you can straight away do it on a mat. So from here, quite often in wrestling, the clinch is quite common position, under, over, control. In MMA as well, in BJJ, this position also occurs. In gi as well, sometimes people holding the belt, holding the sleeve, they are moving around. From here, I'm not sure in BJJ if you're allowed to souplesse, but even if you're not, there is some other ways to take them down with the control. So from here, it is very important to dive a little bit lower than your opponent. So as you are here, you can get the axis, you can get the connection underneath his center of gravity. It's very important. Otherwise, if I just hook him higher on his chest or here, it's hard to do souplesse. I have to go underneath his weight. So from here, as you connect, look, step in, step up there, connect. If you cannot make a full grip, just enough to touch your fingers and then close the elbows. Once you close the elbows, now from here, this leg is going almost underneath his feet. Very important. So you step in to load him. Once you're there, look, with the other foot, you step to the side just to twist him a little bit. So here you are. Once you make the connection, you step in, and now with the other leg, before you move on, try to twist him a little bit. Twist. They always give you a reaction on opposite way. That's what I want. So here, he reacts. I step in, very important, hip. So hip and then bridge up here and move around. Even if you, especially if you haven't done it before, it's not necessary to do such an arch, execute such a motion. Just drill from this position as you are. You step from here as you are, just drill sideways. Get the confidence going. Once you see it's not that bad, then you can execute a bit higher. Hop, yeah, and a bit higher, and so on. So once again, position, under, over, connection, connection. Once you connect, you don't rush. You move around, hop, take the leg, inside trip. He's standing up. Once he stand up, step hip in. Again, stand up, rotation. Stand up, up. Stand up, you gotta hear the hit. The dummy's leg slamming. And do time it. When, if you want to improve the stamina, the endurance, you have to time it for 30 seconds. You gotta be able to throw it 10 times, 15 times. So that's one of the variations of the souplesse with the clinch. Sometimes you can do it without the clinch. You can have underhook position, overhook position. Make sure you tie it up. Close the elbow, connect here, bring him in, glue your head as well. Use the shoulder so it's over touch, it's all glued in. From here, you know, don't need much. So step, and just sideways. Yeah. And very good control here. You can move on for other stuff. So once again, position. So underhook, good connection on the shoulder blade. Even sometimes with the gi, it's advantage. Grab it. Overhook, close the elbow, grab it. From here, step. The other leg coming in, hip, and look away again, look away. So here, look, hop, rotation, cover. Here then now, move on to something else, side control. It depends how he reacts after. Okay. And last variation, because in wrestling, especially in Greco-Roman wrestling, you can witness this throw quite often. In freestyle as well, but not as often. So from here, sometimes, this one which we did, it's called front suplex, which is not as dangerous. Now, next thing, from here is different ways. You can duck under, get the back, and from here you can go back suplex, which is affecting the neck. So from, or sometimes from an arm drag. So you grapple, you wrestle, you've got the connection. You've dragged, as you drag, you step around. From here, you connect it, here you are. You can throw over. Here. Connect, get the back, move on. And as we said, it depends. If you're not allowed in some competitions or in some arts to do such a big arch, just dump it sideways. So here you are, position, you've done the arm drag, you step to the side. From here, it's not necessary to break his knee. Just from here, as you pick him up, as soon as you pick up, even it's not necessary to throw up, just slam it on the floor. Whoa, from here as well, don't do on the neck, just this leg under, load him, rotation, and control from there. It depends on the reaction of your opponent. That's it. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope some of the movements will be useful for you, and not necessarily on the competition, but for stamina. Pick up your stamina, bring your confidence up, it's very important. So here you are again, up connection, glue, don't rush, position, step there, up, straight away stand up, without letting go of the grip, again, straight away stand up, throw, straight away stand up, up, time is going, pick it up, up, there, and so on. Thanks for your time, good luck on your performance. All the best, thank you.